Hello there guys, how are you doing? I hope that I find you all very well indeed and you're all having a brilliant day. Or if you're new, a very warm welcome to you also, because I know there's been quite a lot of you guys subscribed in the last couple of days. So a big thank you, and I've no idea where you've came from. But thanks for stopping by and deciding to subscribe and checking out our wee corner of YouTube. And today I'm making traditional Empire biscuits. You know, these are something that you'll find in every single bakery in Scotland, up and down the country. They're absolutely iconic. Such a simple biscuit and absolutely delicious. Very easy to make and actually quite cheap to make as well. So yeah, so everything that I'm using, I've popped it in the description box down below, just in case you want to follow along. So this is what I'm using today. First of all, I've got 250 grams of room temperature butter. You can use salted or unsalted, it doesn't really matter in this recipe. I've got 130 grams of sifted caster sugar. I've got 500 grams of plain or all-purpose flour. Again, you're going to want to sift this. I've got 200 grams of sifted icing sugar. I've got a few tablespoons of strawberry jam. I've got one large egg. I've got a handful of jelly tots. Now, you can use jelly sweets or you can use glace cherries. These are just quite traditional. Or you can use sprinkles. It's up to you. And I'm also using half a teaspoon of vanilla extract. And you're also going to need a couple of tablespoons of warm water just to add to your icing for decorating the top. Yeah, so let's move on and we'll see what we've got next. So as usual, this is the vanilla extract that I'm using. It's actually vanilla bean paste and this is my favourite. It's not the cheapest out there, but it's got a lovely flavour. And this is the jam that I use in most things that I bake. It's got quite a high fruit content, which, you know, it makes all the difference. It gives it a lovely fruity flavour and a proper strawberry flavour rather than being artificial. I think it's about 50% fruit, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, it's 50 grams per 100 grams of jam, so it's really quite high. So I recommend this if you can get a hold of it. But again, it's up to you. So today I'm going to be using my stand mix. I haven't used this for ages. It's just I'm a bit pushed for time, so this is going to make it a lot quicker. You can do this by hand as well, of course, if you prefer. And if you're using a stand mix, you'd want to use a paddle attachment or a dough hook if you have one. You don't want to use a whisk for this. So first thing I do is pop in my room temperature butter. This is 250 grams and I've just cubed it up. And then to that, I'm going to add my caster sugar. So this is 130 grams of sifted caster sugar. And then I'm just going to cream these two together. So you want to start off on a low speed and then gradually increase it to a high speed for a couple of minutes. And it'll become lovely and yellow and light and fluffy. But halfway through, you just want to stop and scrape down the sides of your bowl, because it all sort of disappears up the side of your bowl for some reason. So just about after a minute, give it a wee scrape down with a spatula and get it back into the bottom of your bowl. And then just give it another minute after that. This is going to give your biscuit a lovely texture. So it's quite important. Again, you can do this by hand. Just make sure it's well incorporated. And then you're going to pop in your egg. So just put it into the middle. And I just like to grab my spatula again and just sort of take the mixture off the sides of the bowl and, you know, pop it on top. Just something I do. You don't have to do this. And then you want to get your mixer back on and make sure that's well mixed in. Just give it about 30 seconds to a minute. It doesn't take long. And then once your egg is thoroughly combined, you can start adding in your flour. Now, I like to do this in two stages. So I put half of my flour in, which is 250 grams of plain flour. Give that a good mix in. And then I add in the other half. It just stops it from flying about too much. And that's your other 250 grams. And again, just give this a good whisk or mix and it'll form a really stiff dough. And at that point, you want to get it out and onto your work surface. When your mixture, you know, when it starts to struggle with your mixture, you'll know when it's ready, you'll be able to tell. So when you're at this stage, you want to flour your work surface. And you can form it into a sort of ball. So again, this is just plain flour. And then just tip your bowl out on top of that. And don't worry if you think it's, you know, if it looks dry or anything, because it will be dry. Just that's just the type of mixture that it is. But just give it a good squish together and it will come together. And you'll be able to roll this out. So you want to grab your rolling pin and just pop some flour around it just to prevent any sticking. And you want to roll this out to about a centimetre thick, because bearing in mind, you know, you are going to be doubling these biscuits up, so you don't want them too thick. And then once you're happy, you can grab yourself a cookie cutter. Now the one I'm using is 2.5 inches. And I'm going to get, like I said, I'll get about 24 biscuits out of this, which when they're doubled up obviously gives you 12 cookies. So just go around your whole mixture. Make sure to use the fluted side because that's going to give you that traditional look. And I'm just using, you know, my wee spatula thing just to pick them up. It just makes it a wee bit easier. And they come off really easily. I mean, you know, they don't stir, they shouldn't stick or anything. Just as long as you've floured your surface properly, you know, you'll find them quite easy to pick up. I'm just popping mine onto a baking tray, which is lined with greaseproof paper, which is out of shot. You know, you can remould this mixture as often or as many times as you need to, just to get, you know, the most biscuits out of your mixture. So just keep rolling away and cutting out your shapes and remoulding and cutting out your shapes until you've no dough left. Then once you're happy and you've got all your biscuits onto your tray, you want to put this into a preheated oven at gas mark 4 or 180°C for about 12 to 15 minutes. Now you don't want any colour on these at all. They should be lovely and pale, just like this. This was mine just out of the oven, because they are traditionally very pale. So you just want to let these cool now. So I've just transferred mine onto a wire rack. They don't take long to cool, probably about an hour. Just so that when you put your icing on, you know, it doesn't slide all over the place. And then once they're cool, you just want to flip them over so you've got the rough side up. And on half of them, you just want to put your jam. And then just smooth it out to the edge, or more or less to the edge, because when you put the other half on, it's going to squash it down anyway. And then you just want to sandwich your other half together. And put your best half upwards. And just give it a wee gentle squeeze and the jam will come to the edge. Just try and line them up so that the lines meet up. So just do that for all your biscuits. These smell absolutely amazing. And we're now going to do the icing just after this. I mean, it's really simple. It's just icing sugar, water, and a wee bit of vanilla. But you want it quite thick. So into a bowl, you want to pop your icing sugar. This is 200 grams of sifted icing sugar. And to that, you want to add 2 tablespoons of hot water. And 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. And just give the whole thing a good stir round. Like I said, you want it quite thick. And this is what you're looking for. So that's ideal. And I've just popped mine into a piping bag, but you can, of course, just use a knife or a spoon if you like. I wanted mine right in the centre, so that's why I've done this. But you don't want them too perfect. I mean, when you go to the bakers or, you know, if you see these in the shops, they're never perfect. So you don't really want them perfect because you want that sort of rustic look, that sort of homemade look. Or that's the way I've, you know, we've always found them, or, you know, whenever I've picked them up in the shop, they've always looked sort of a wee bit skee-whiff. And then just before your icing sets, you just want to pop your jelly tot into the centre, or a glacé cherry if that's what you're using. And then you just want to let them set completely. Probably take about an hour, 2 hours to set completely, but that's them done. And I've just had one more cup of tea and I can let you know they're absolutely divine. So if you've never had an Empire biscuit, you know, I really do recommend you give it a go. They're so simple and absolutely delicious with a cup of tea or a cup of coffee. Like I said, anywhere you go in this country, you get into a baker and you'll definitely find them. It's just one of those things. They're an absolute iconic biscuit, and iconic for a good reason. So thank you very much again, guys, for popping over and seeing what's going on. And I'll catch up with you again in a couple of days and we'll take it from there. So take care of yourselves and I'll see you later. Bye for now. Bye now.